Today we are going to be building the STELR solar car, which will convert energy provided from the sun to mechanical motion. To build the car, you'll need its body, which contains a printed electrical circuit, and a blue capacitor, which stores energy like a fuel tank in an ordinary car. The solar panels are what convert the energy from the sun to electricity. When light hits these photovoltaic cells with enough energy to knock electrons loose, electrical conductors can be connected and electricity can be generated. Then, the electrical motor converts this electricity into mechanical motion. We have four wheels which, using friction where they touch the road, allow the tyres to roll and the car to move. The back two wheels can be directly connected to the electric motor shaft, whereas the front two wheels are mounted to the car with an additional axle. Additionally, we have screws, washers, nuts, and rubber bands to help us combine the components, alligator clips for wire stripping, grease for the gearbox to help reduce unwanted frictional losses, as well as wire to make electrical connections, and pliers and a screwdriver. Now fundamentally, electrical wire is made up of a metallic core, which conducts electricity, and a coating of insulation, which provides protection to the circuit and to us. To make electrical connections, we need to strip this coating. Let's cut off a piece of wire to practice on. While gripping the wire roughly 1 centimeter away from the end with the pliers, and 0.5 centimeter away from the end with the alligator clips, spin the alligator clips around the wire a few times to lightly cut the outer plastic, before pulling the alligator clips away from the pliers to remove a portion of the wire's outer layer. Try practicing this again on the other side of the wire. If the STELR solar car kit has been built before, the wires on the motor and solar panels will already have been stripped. Whereas, if the kit is new, these wires will need to be stripped. If this is the case, using the wire stripping method previously outlined, strip the ends of the wires to expose the metallic core on the electrical motor and the solar panels, while being careful not to pull the wires off either of these components. To attach the motor to the body of the car, we will need the pliers, bolts, washers, and nuts, and a screwdriver. The motor should be orientated such that the wires stick out to the center of the car. Place a bolt in the hole on the frame of the motor and then align the motor on the body so that this bolt slides through the relevant hole in the frame. Being careful not to let this bolt fall out, place a washer over the bolt on the other side of the body, followed by the nut, which needs to be screwed on in a clockwise direction. Remember, righty-tighty, lefty-loosey. Ensuring that the metal shaft coming out of the motor is at right angles to the length of the body, repeat this on the other side of the motor frame. Note that one of the screws is placed on a line rather than a hole, and this can be used to later adjust the angle of the shaft to make the car turn. However, let's ignore this for now, and while holding the nut in place with the pliers, tighten both bolts so that the motor is firm and well aligned. Now, after all that hard work, this still doesn't look like a car, but it soon will. Firmly push two tyres onto either side of the electric motor shaft, then squirt some grease onto the grooves of the gears and slowly spin the wheels to ensure that the grease is spread evenly. This grease will reduce frictional losses in the gearbox, giving the car better durability and efficiency. Now it's starting to look like a car, but we have to make it solar. Therefore, we need to attach the solar panels to the top of the car like so, making special note of which way the wires are facing. Using one of the rubber bands provided, loop one end to the body, then place the solar panel down on the foam surface, and ensuring the rubber bands pass in between the two wires, stretch it over the solar panel, and secure it on the second end of the rubber band onto the other side of the car's body. Then, rinse and repeat with the second solar panel. Now it's time to build the front axle's frame and attach the remaining tyres to the car. Firstly, insert the two identical front axle frame pieces into the slit on each side of the car's body, followed by the longer piece, which, with a little bit of force, goes in. Then attach one of the tyres to the axle before inserting it through the frame's holes and pushing on the last tyre. Ta-da! When under sunlight, each of the solar panels can create approximately 1.5 volts of potential. However, the electric motor needs an input of 3 volts to run. By connecting the solar panels in series, we add their voltages together, creating the 3 volts needed for the motor. The simplest way to get this car to run is to connect the solar panels directly to the motor like this. When under sunlight, the solar panels create a current that flows through the motor, causing the car to move. But what happens if we don't want the wheels to move every time the car goes in the sun? We need a switch. This switch works by connecting the top two exposed nodes together when the switch is up, and connecting the bottom two exposed nodes when the switch is down. When we have the switch down, the electrical circuit is incomplete, causing no current to flow around the circuit and through the motor. Then, when we desire, we can push the switch up, which connects the top two nodes, thus completing the circuit and causing current to flow around the circuit and through the motor. Now, what happens if this car needs to drive through a patch of shade? Without a form of energy storage, the motor would stop as soon as sun stops shining and the car would be stuck in the shade. Similar to a battery, which stores electrical energy as chemical energy, a capacitor stores energy in the form of an electric field and is kind of like a short-term battery, and sometimes is blue, like in our case. We could directly connect the capacitor to the solar panels, and this would charge the capacitor when the car was in sunlight. However, switches are awesome, so we are going to wire the capacitor through the switch so that we can choose when we want to connect the capacitor to the solar panels for charging and when we don't. Let's put the motor back into the picture. Connecting one of the motor terminals to the positive terminal of the solar panels and capacitor, and the other motor terminal to the negative terminals of the solar panels and the capacitor. By pushing both of the switches into the middle of the car, we are disconnecting the motor and the capacitor from the solar panels. So let's think of this as the off-off position for the switches. Now, the sun is shining, the solar panels are gleaming. However, because both of the switches are off, nothing will happen. And remember kids, Mr. Sun says, be cool and stay in school. Now if we turn the top switch on, the motor will be connected and the solar panels will convert energy from the sun to electricity, which will flow through the electric motor, causing the wheels to spin and the car to move. Sweet. If we turn the bottom switch to the on position, the capacitor will now be connected, so that while the motor is running, any excess energy from the solar panels will be stored in the capacitor. Now, disaster strikes. The sun is no longer shining, but never fear, Mrs. Blue Capacitor is here. Therefore, even when the sun isn't shining, the capacitor is able to automatically kick in and start providing energy to the motor. Note that in the handbook provided, this red wire is actually connected like this. However, this variation is only aesthetic since both options do the same job. Now, we just need to build these wire connections in real life. So, let's start cutting pieces that are long enough to connect between the terminals. Then, using the wire stripping method that we talked about previously, we can strip off the ends of the wires, getting them ready to connect between each of the terminals. Sometimes it helps to create loops with the end of the wires, and with these loops you can hook them around the screw, which makes it easier to tighten it in and make all the electrical connections you need for that node. During the video, if you're wondering about the difference between red wires and black wires, well, it's just the color. The wires are actually the same, it's just a different colored paint. Thank you. So that's it. Thanks for watching the video on how to assemble a STELR solar car. Have fun racing!
Back to work.